My name is Sean Cavanaugh. I'm a senior consulting engineer here at Cumulus Networks. For this video, we're going to talk about ACLs or access lists. We're going to look at Cisco NXOS command line config and what the rendered config is. We're going to compare that to Cumulus Linux. On the Cumulus Linux box, we use IP tables under the hood. So we're actually implementing IP tables rules just like a Linux Debian server would. However, when you see the word access lists, IP tables, or net filter, they all refer to the same thing, and that's the ability to block traffic or police traffic, and it's a stateless firewall. So I'm on a Cisco NXOS device. I'm going to go ahead and configure terminal. I'm going to create an access list, and you get to call it a user-defined variable, so I'm just going to block web traffic, so it's an easy access list to compare. So I'm going to do IP access list, and then we call it, I'm going to use all caps for user-defined variables, and we're going to just call it block HTTP. I'm going to do a deny TCP any equal W. And that's a keyword www that is port 80. And then we're gonna assign this access list to an interface. We're gonna do interface E11. We're gonna do IP access group block. And then we're gonna block all traffic coming in that port. I'm gonna go ahead and end, write the config to persistent memory. And then we can verify that it's actually in there. We can do a show IP access list. And there's a lot of control plane access lists on this box already. So I'm just gonna go ahead and type in the block HTTP. So we can just look at that access list. And we see here that it does a deny TCP any equal web traffic. And you also see that it's a number 10. By default, if you don't specify it, it just did 10. Here I am on the Cumulus Linux box. I'm gonna go ahead and create an access list called block HTTP. So we'll do net add ACL IPv4 block HTTP. And that's again a user defined variable. I'm gonna kind of show you the options here. So we can accept, drop, and et cetera here. So I'm gonna drop TCP, and then we're gonna do source IP any, source port any, dest IP any, and then what we care about is dest port, and we'll tab. And you can see here, just like the Cisco box, we have the ability just to do www traffic. In this case, we just say HTTP. We also have to apply to the interface, just like the Juniper and Cisco. So we do net add interface switch port 1 ACL IPv4, and then we do block HTTP inbound. Then we're going to go ahead and do a net commit. And then we can do a net show configuration ACL to verify the configuration state. And we can actually even see the rendered config under etc cumulus ACL policy D. And then you'll see that there's a 50 ACL rules that's created. This is the actual flat file that it manipulates if you ever want to automate against the flat file. And you can see the actual IP tables rule here. In summary, the Cumulus Linux box uses net, so we can do a net add ACL, and then you can tab complete for all the options you want. If you want V4, you do IPv4. If you want V6, IPv6, and then you name the access list. And then you apply it to the interface. The rendered config is going to look like this, and of course there's also the IP tables rendered config. With the Cisco box, we're going to configure terminal, we create the access list, and then we can do a deny. If you don't specify the port, if you do any, it doesn't care. So it's just a little bit less verbose than the Cumulus box. And then here we can do interface E11, and then we apply the access group there. And then of course the rendered config looks like this. Thank you for listening.